Quentin Carter here, InfoWars Nightly News, here with Craig Sawman Sawyer. Got some hot topics we'd like to discuss. Craig, how's it going, man?
It's going well. Thanks for having me on, Q.
Absolutely. So let's talk a little bit about some of the breaking news and things that we've discussed earlier today. Let's do it on air.
Yeah, man. Well, one of the first things is the pedophilia ring that are being rolled up and busted right now. It seems like our DOJ is in rapid fire yanking these pedophiles up, and I'm hearing hundreds and some reports even reporting thousands of pedophiles across the country being rolled up already. And I'm so thankful for not only for the victims, but for just the sanity and the soul of the nation to see that that's being cleaned up. I celebrate that now.
Absolutely. I'm super thankful that the DOJ is doing their part to go out and start wrangling these people up. Recently read an article, 750 arrested, 28 plus children saved from, you know, this type of sick imprisonment.
Yeah. Well, I hope not only that the victims can recover, but that there will be far fewer in the future. And man, I really celebrate. I hope the rest of the of our country will join us in celebrating that development. That's a beautiful, beautiful thing.
And I hope that as the DOJ rounds these guys up and snatches them up and gives them just punishment for what they're doing, I hope that it's a lesson and an idea for other people that are out doing this, that it's not okay, that your turn is coming, that if you continue to do what it is that you're doing, it's just a matter of time before your door gets knocked on, whether it's daytime or nighttime.
Kicked in.
Someone's coming to get you. Like, you can be sure of it.
Yeah, I've got friends. In fact, we've got a network that we've built. I won't say the location, but it's the epicenter of human trafficking in the continental United States to break that up. And what we want to do is make a television series about it. Not to just entertain people, but to make the public aware so that we can create a non-permissive environment for these human traffickers, for these pedophiles, and break up the ring and make it very difficult for them to do what they do. In many cases, they're even keeping girls in little dog kennels, and they're doing it right under people's noses, sometimes in nice neighborhoods. And the neighbors don't even know why 20 or 30 cars there in a 24-hour period means something. And so what we want to do is show the public, this is what's going on, in a lot of cases right under your nose, see something, say something. Right. And we want to heat this issue up and cause it to be very difficult and allow a lot of these girls to have a better life, and young boys too, and just break this up. This is evil,
so
and this should not be happening.
It's not just poor neighborhoods, it's rich neighborhoods. It crosses all lines. Ethnically, you know, it's white, it's black, it's everyone does it. It's financials, you know, rich people, poor people.
Yeah. Well, so much of it is the elites too, because it gets suppressed.
Right.
There are people that have done good work and exposed a lot of this, and it doesn't get seen by the public because the officials are suppressing the information because they're in on it, sadly
people
enough.
People would be less likely to partake in this type of stuff if they saw it on the news on a regular basis, if they saw that the bad guys were being caught, that people were being prosecuted, sent to prison, you know, getting just punishment.
Yeah.
And you had said that at the end of each show, you don't want it to just be a tearjerker where someone feels completely miserable. You know, at the end of every show, we want to show the young ladies and the young men living prosperous lives, getting the therapy that they need to move forward.
Yeah, absolutely. That's part of the story. We want to share that with people as the rescues and the rehabilitation. There's equine therapy that these young people are responding to very, very powerfully and positively. Horses, man, it just seems like a magic combination, the way that humans interact with horses and just watch these, you know, precious little souls recover and have that part of the story shared at the end of each episode.
Right, because you might reach out to someone who has been hurt, who has been abused, who has been in one of these situations that thinks there's no hope, that they're not recoverable. And that's kind of the idea, is to be able to show that the people that have been through this, they're still helpable, they're still fixable. Just because you've had a hard time doesn't necessarily mean that that's your life. You know, there are steps forward. There are people that recover from this. There's a whole network of individuals out there that will help you get better.
Yeah, man, a lot of good people out there that want to help and are already doing it. So why not share that with the public and let them celebrate the positive aspect of it and then the healing that can come once this evil is broken and put down. You know, we've got the International Coalition Against Poaching. We've got a fantastic team of Tier 1 operators and intelligence community veterans who really can wire any city out and find out who the bad guys are and have a huge impact. So we want to transfer that also into the human trafficking and have a tremendous impact there.
And since you brought up the intelligence community, let us, you know, kind of say that I think a lot of times a lot of people get lumped into the term CIA, you know, and it has a super negative connotation right now. I want to take this time while I'm on here to say that, you know, I have friends and family in the intelligence community. And when I say family, I mean, you know, guys that I have served next to and spent time with that I would kill or die for in an instant. They're not bad people at all. They are doing God's work. Without them, there is, you know, no list, no shortage of atrocities that would happen to the United States or the United States people if these guys weren't out there doing what they do. You know, so I just want to clarify that not everybody's lumped into that same little group.
You know, Q, I hear people out there speaking about the intelligence community, the CIA, so forth, and they have this really negative image in their mind of perhaps part of our intelligence community that has been abused or used for nefarious reasons. And
right. And
you and I both know a lot of people that are doing God's work there that are patriots to the core, and they're risking life and limb to secure us. Heroes, literally heroes.
Absolutely.
Risking life and limb.
Keeping us safe in the United States of America.
And so to the people that have heard so much of the negativity, I would say this. What I would like to hear happen is President Trump, because he is our elected official to carry out our will of the people, he can direct his own or appoint his own directors to each branch of the intelligence community and set his commander's intent with, hey, Director, here is my intent. Here is our new charter. It is what you're supposed to have been doing all along to act in the good faith of the American people. And I will hold you accountable, and you are to clean up whatever might be wrong with your agency and get back on track.
That's right.
And so that the American public can regain confidence in so many good people that are working in our IC for us.
Basically, Trump needs to assign responsibility and then hold people accountable.
100%.
That's it. I think the American people have lost a faith that needs to be restored. Understand there are good people out there doing good work. They're in the shadows. It's kind of the whole silent professional. You know, the work doesn't stop because no one's talking about it.
Correct.
Still out there doing stuff every single day.
Yeah. It's quiet because it needs to be. That's what's more effective.
Okay. And that's, you know, part of that is we don't want to be quiet anymore. We want to talk about this veteran initiative. It's a call to action, right? So part of me calling you here is, you know, let's reach out. Let's talk. Let's be vocal. Let's stand up for what's right. Let's, you know, support the guys that are in charge. You know, there's an old saying, you know, lead, follow, or get out of the way.
Yeah, man.
Right?
Yeah, man.
Right now it's kind of time to follow.
Yeah.
So we're following the boss, but we want to lead people in the right direction. And that's
right. What's
big for me right now. That's what I, you know, my vision behind this and having you guys come and talk and do whatever, that's exactly what I want to do.
Yeah.
I want people like you and I to lead people that are on the sidelines and maybe not interacting as much. I want those people to come out and feel safe and be proud of who they are. You know, put your right hand over your heart. You know, say the Pledge of Allegiance, you know, listen to Star Spangled Banner, be proud of having an American flag in front of your home again.
Yes, together we are what we can't be alone, free country.
That's it.
And what's wrong with that? So I think we need to get happy about it and celebrate what we've got and beat away those that would tear it down.
Totally agree.
Yeah, man.
You know, Craig, I want to thank you very much for coming out, brother. I love you. You know that.
Thank you so much. This has been a fantastic experience.
Please do.
I will.
For more reports just like this, tune in to InfoWars.com.
So again, if you want to get our videos, so you can make your decision whether you want to see them or not. After all, that's why you subscribe. YouTube's had this since they started, and they're fundamentally changing it so you don't get it. Click on the bells so you get the notifications, and so you get in your feed the videos and channels you've subscribed to.